नमस्ते स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे लेट अस डिस्कस ए मैक्सिमा एंड मिनिमा। व्हेन द फंक्शन वी कॉल्ड एज मैक्सिमा एंड मिनिमा, व्हाट इज द डेफिनेशन ऑफ दैट मींस? लेट एफ बी ए फंक्शन डिफाइंड ऑन द इंटरवल आई। हियर वी आर गोइंग टू टेक एन इंटरवल आई जनरली, देन एफ इज सेड टू बी मैक्सिमम वैल्यू इन द गिवन इंटरवल आई। दैट पर्टिकुलर इफ देयर एग्जिस्ट अ पॉइंट इन दैट पॉइंट सी in I such that which condition is holds good, f of c greater than or equal to f of x. If this condition is satisfied, the given function is maximum for all x belongs to I. That x value we are going to choose from the interval I. When this definition if it holds good, the given function is maximum. Second point, before that the number f of c, f of x function is generally c. F of x is, for example, if you choose as x square in the from the interval, for example 2, 4, if I choose as an interval 2, 4, in that one if you choose three element, if you choose, will get f of 3 is 3 square, value is 9, means that you will get a constant value. That's why we call as the number f of c. The number f of c is called the maximum value of f, means some value we are going to choose from the interval, after substituting in the function some value will get, that is the maximum value. The maximum value of f in the interval I generally, and the point c, what you have taken that value, that one is called point of maximum value of f in I. In this case 3 is the maximum value of f in I, like that. Okay, this is the definition of maximum. Second point, if f is said to have a minimum value in the interval I, generally I, if there exists a point c in I, one point I am going to choose generally as c in interval such that, this symbol is such that f of c less than or equal to f of x. If this condition is it holds good, f of c less than or equal to f of x for all x belongs to I. This definition, if it is holds good in the case, the given function is minimum value. Same how we explained first one, the same thing, the number f of c, after substituting the c value in the given function, what will give the answer? That one we call as minimum value of f in I. Which point we are going to take the from the interval I? That one we call as the point c. Generally, I choose as c. The point c is called a point of minimum value of f in I. This is the definition of maximum and minimum value. Next concept is extreme value. When we call as extreme value in the case means a real function, means we are learning from real value functions only. The either we can use real function or simply function also. A real function f is said to have an extreme value. When we call as the given function is an extreme value in the case in interval I, if there exists a point c in I such that f is either a maximum value or a minimum value in the case, we call as extreme value. That what number we are choosing from the interval, that one, the number f of c is called as extreme value of the function. Here the point c is called the extreme point, means f of c is called extreme value, f of c value, the point c is called as extreme point. One best example of the extreme point means sin x and cos x function. This is one of the best example of extreme point and extreme value. This is neither increasing nor decreasing, both is steady. Okay, that's right. This is one of the example of extreme value and extreme point. Next is concept is monotonic function. When the function we call as monotonic function means a real function f is said to be monotonic in an interval I if f is either increasing nor decreasing. Already we learnt or decreasing, not or decreasing. We know when the function is increasing and decreasing, if we choose x1 less than x2, then f of x1 greater than or equal to f of x2 in
The same interval f of x1 less than f of x2, that if it satisfies the case decreasing, we know. In this one, if it is either increasing or decreasing in either case, the real function we call as monotonic. That functions we call as monotonic. Special name is there, that is monotonic. Next is, every monotonic function f assumes its maximum or minimum value at the end points of the domain of f. For example, if we consider as one of monotonic function, in that one, if the function, if it is maximum or minimum, for example, this side is maximum, this side is minimum, if you assume that, this one is end point, if I consider that at the end points of the domain, this one, which and all value is there, that it will come under domain of F. So, that every monotonic function, either maximum or minimum, will come under the point of domain of F. Next is, last point, every continuous function on a closed interval has a maxima and a minima. Yes, it is true. We know every continuous function is closed interval on AB. That one we learned already. But if it is a closed interval, means that every continuous function will get a maximum also, minimum value also. Now let us discuss local maxima and local minima. When the function is local maxima and local minima, what is the difference of maxima and minima means? Let f be a real valued function and c be an interior point in the domain of F. Then c is called a point of local maxima if there is a point x greater than 0 such that f of c greater than or equal to f of x for all x belongs to c minus h comma c plus h. But what we learnt already, what do you mean by maximum? Same definition, but in that one, h is not there, but particularly interval it has called as I. But now, c minus h and c plus h is there. What's the meaning of this and that means? I means any interval, but in this one, c, h means the h greater than 0, any value we can take, either 1 or 2, whatever. But greater than 0, much we can take greater than 0 only. C value is one value we can take. For example, this one is if you take h value 2 from the interval 2, 10 in that case, then c value if I choose 3, what will you get? 2 minus h. C minus means 3 minus 2, 3 plus 2 will get 1, 5. We'll get the interval this one. So generally we'll get c minus h and comma c plus h. That c point, if it satisfied f of c greater than or equal to f of x, in that case, the given function called as local maxima. The point, the number f of c is called a local maximum value of f of x. Same thing, f of x is, if I assume one of the function, that is parabolic function, if I choose x square in that case, if I choose in between the value 3 or 2, if I consider in that case, f of 2 means it becomes 2 square value is 4 it's getting. 4 it's getting means the number f of c, c type like this. The number f of c is called a local maximum value of f. What you are choosing the value c, that one is called as a point of local maximum value of f. Okay. Next is, when the c point is called a local minimum value, when the point c is a local minimum, when we call as, means the same condition, h greater than 0 we can take, such that if the condition, if it is satisfied, f of c less than or equal to f of x for all x belongs to c minus h comma c plus h. General interval, if I in between this value, if it is satisfied this condition, that we call as c is called a point of local minimum or local minimum. The number f of c is called a local minimum value of f. Which point we are choosing from the interval, that c value, if it substitute in the function, given function, what will get the value, that one we call as local minimum value of f. Then now, how to test whether the function is local maxima or local minima is, there are two types is there. One is first order, first derivative test. Another one is second derivative test. help of first derivative test, what is the procedure we are going to discuss now. First derivative test, how to apply means, when the function, whatever, whether it is a polynomial, whatever, first we should differentiate the function, that is first step. Second step, solve f dash of x is equal to 0. How we solve, how we calculate, whether the function is steeply increasing or steeply decreasing, find the intervals. On that case, how we solve, that method only we can apply. First, we can calculate the critical points. F dash of x is equal to 0. First derivative is the substitute 0, we'll get the x value. X value, what will it get? That one generally I consider as a, b, c, etc. Depends on your equation. Will get more than the value also, more than ABC value also. Sometimes will get only one root, but sometimes will get two roots, sometimes three roots, depends on your function. Our solution, these solutions are called critical points. Next is, determine the sign of f dash of x in the neighborhood of the critical points, say x is equal to c. For example, what you get the critical point, that one, for example, if you assume that a, in a real line, minus infinity comma infinity, you got the value a, we'll get two intervals, one is minus infinity comma a, another one is a comma infinity, and one more point is there, x is equal to a. In this point, whether that one we call as critical point. After that, so this one, f dash of x changes sign from positive to negative. Changes sign from positive to negative as x increases through f dash of x greater than 0, then x is called a point of maximum. What it means and how to represent in a diagram way means, see, when the function means generally if I get like this curve in the case, this one, if it is positive, derivative means already I said, if it is a smooth curve in the case, if it is possible to draw a tangent. If you assume that in this case it is possible to draw a tangent, their derivative is getting f dash of. At which point, some point I am going to choose, that is if I consider c, means f dash of c. Is it increasing? Upper it is there. That's why I am going to write greater than 0. Because we know condition from the theorem statement, when the function is increasing, then how to check whether the function is increasing through theorem means, their derivative some point f dash of x it is greater than 0, in that case the given function is increasing, we know. That theorem we can apply now. Greater than 0 means this is increasing. If it downwards in that case, see, one point if I am taking, this one is at point some case, then this one is f dash of c less than 0. First it is increases, next it is decreases. But in this point is maximum, see, exchanges sign from positive to negative as x increases. How as x increases means, see, this one is 0, this one is x, this one is y. For example, if you assume 0, this is 1, end point if it is 1 is, then it moves from this side means x value is increases only, not decreases. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 value. So as positive, sign from positive to negative, as x increases, positive to negative, but x increases through c, f dash of x greater than 0, but this point is, at x is equal to c point is called as point of maxima. Means, in this point, we will get a critical point, that point, if you substitute in the function, given function, we will get a maximum value. That one particular name we call as local maximum, means this c value substitute in the given function will get a maximum value. Next is, if f dash of x changes sign from negative to positive, changes sign from negative to positive means, see, for example, if the curve comes like this, in that case, either we should write in the downwards also, that one does not matter. If it is a smooth curve means, already I said, it is possible to draw a tangent. That is, see, downwards, I started from this side, this is x axis, this is y, x value is increases. In this also, x value is increases. From this point to this point, first it is lower point, then it is increases.
means this one is f dash of c less than 0. See why I am writing means, for example, one point if I choose, generally I took as c. Generally, if it is choose as 2 means f of 2 will come. Okay, that depends on you, but I am choosing now generally f dash of c less than 0. Later, if I draw the tangent from this side means, at this point means, that curve is increases. Means f dash of c will get the condition greater than 0. Means first it is decreases, then it will be increases. But this one point is, in between these two intervals, we will get one critical point. What we got from this condition, f dash of x in the place substitute 0, we will get a critical point. That critical point, if I consider as somewhere a, b, c, whatever c, if I consider that their derivative value is equal to 0, then first it is decreases, then it is increases. If it comes in the case, this point we call as f is local minima. F is local minima. This one is f is local maxima. Then third point, if f dash of x does not change the sign of a critical point, so sign does not change, in that case it is an extreme, it is not an extreme point, that condition we call that point of inflection. Now, based on this condition means, we discuss it from first derivative test, I explained it generally, this general we have to apply in the problem. Now we are going to discuss problems under first derivative test. Now let us discuss the problems and find the local maxima and local minima of the function f of x is equal to x cube plus 1, x belongs to R. Then with the help of first derivative test, how to get to know the given function is local maxima and local minima means. See, the given function is f of x is equal to x cube plus 1. What I said in generally, first that we should calculate their critical points. Then how to calculate their critical points means, the given function we should differentiate with respect to x. Means differentiate this function with respect to x, we get f dash of x is 3x square plus this derivative value, constant derivative value is 0. Now put simultaneously right side we should be simplified and left side f dash of x in the place simply substitute 0 also. Put f dash of x is equal to 0, we'll get 0 is equal to 3x square, the next value will get 0 by 3 value 0 only, x value is plus or minus 0, but 0 is not the is not plus or minus is not there in 0, so 0 is 0 only, x value will get 0. Means the point, we'll get one critical point, x is equal to 0 is a one critical point. Now, the point x is equal to 0 which divides the real line will get two intervals, because only one critical point if it exists in the case will get two real lines, will get two intervals, namely C. If it is real line minus infinity to plus infinity, all value will come in a real line. In that one point will get a critical point. Which and all intervals will get? Minus infinity comma 0 and 0 comma infinity. Minus infinity comma 0 and 0 comma infinity. Now we got the two intervals. With the help of table, how to check whether the function is local maxima and local minima means. Apply first derivative test. Now, table we should write first. First step, first column is interval. How we applied when find the intervals when the function is strictly increasing and decreasing, like that only. But one column is extra. Interval, this column is extra. F of x column is extra. F of x, this one is f dash of x, and last column is
nature of f. See, f dash of x means after differentiating x getting value 3x square we should write. Now, see, in this one, first interval minus infinity comma 0. Now, minus infinity comma 0, in between minus infinity to 0, except 0, any value we can take. That value we should substitute in this f dash of x place. Whether we'll get positive or negative, we should think. For example, if I choose minus infinity to 0, if I choose minus 1 or minus 2, that value if I choose in this place, minus 1 or minus 2, minus 3, whatever, square is there means we'll get positive. Positive into 3 value is always positive. So we'll get f dash of x is positive. That it means their derivative is always greater than 0. Is always greater than 0 means f is increasing, it's getting f is increasing. Okay, means f dash of x. Now only I explained through graph. F dash of x greater than 0 is exist. Now in this one, don't write anything because in the interval we are discussing. Now, next point, critical point we should write in this place, x is equal to 0. This value substitute in the function. The given function is which one? X cube plus 1. Then what will get the value? F of x value. X value is 0. If I substitute in this place, we'll get value is 0. Cube plus 1 is nothing but 1. In this place, don't substitute. Now, next is 0, infinity. 0, infinity. If I substitute, if I take any value in between this interval, for example, 1, if I choose in the case, 1 will get. 1 square value is 1 only. 1 square value is 1 only means that value is 1 square value 1, 1 into 3 is 3. 3 means positive. Positive means greater than 0. F is increasing. Observe, f is increasing. In this case also increasing. Again, this case also increasing. But one interval if it is increasing, next interval if it is decreasing means we call as this point is local maximum. Means at this point it exists the value 1. That one is a local maximum if it is possible to tell. One interval if it is greater than 0, another interval if it is less than 0 if it comes. But if it is one value less than 0, another interval if it is greater than 0 means that critical point if it is possible to call local minimum. But now both value is increasing. Both value is increasing means we can't tell whether it is local maxima also, local minimum also. Then what to do? What is the answer? Means f is neither maxima nor minima. F is neither maxima nor minima. In this function, it is not neither maxima nor minima. Or neither maxima, or we can write local maxima. Neither local maxima nor local minima. And last, we should write the conclusion result. This one, there is no point of local maxima and local minima in a given function. F of x is x cube plus 1. There is no point of local maxima and local maxima and local minima in the given point. So this is the conclusion result. Okay. Next problem is find the local maxima and local minima of the function f of x is 9 square plus 12 x plus 2 is there. The given function is a quadratic equation. Then we should write first again 9 square plus 12 x plus 2. Differentiate this function with respect to x. We'll get f dash of x is equal to 9 into x square value is 2x plus 12 into x with respect to x value is 1 plus 0. Now put, simplify right side and left side f dash of x in the place substitute 0 also. What will get? 0 is equal to 18x plus 12. 18x is equal to minus 12, x is equal to minus 12 by 18, x is equal to means value what will get? 6 2s are 6 3s are. So minus 2 by 3. We will get only one critical point. Is a critical point. Now, the point x is equal to minus 2 by 3, which divides the real line, we'll get the intervals, namely, see, if I consider minus infinity to plus infinity, we'll get one critical point is minus 2 by 3, which are all intervals is getting? Minus infinity, comma, minus 2 by 3 and minus 2 by 3, comma, infinity. We got two intervals from this equation. Now, apply first order derivative. Apply first derivative test. First derivative test. With that one, first write the column. First column is interval. Second column is f of x. Third column is f dash of x. Fourth column is nature of f. From the nature of f case only, we can able to tell the given function is whether it is local maxima or local minima. The given function f of x is, see, 9x square plus 12x plus 2 is there. F dash of x means, after simplifying, is getting value 18x plus 12. 18x plus 12 means we can able to common, we can take 3 is common, we'll get, so 6 if we can take common, we'll get 3x plus 2, nature of f. Next is, from first interval is minus infinity comma minus 2 by 3. If we choose the interval in the case, that value we have to substitute in the f dash of x. F dash of x, if I substitute, for example, minus 2 by 3 to minus infinity comma minus 2 by 3. From this value, any value if I take, this one if I substitute in this place, we'll get negative only. We'll get negative means less than 0. When the derivative if it is less than 0, means f is decreasing. Okay. Next is, at x is equal to critical point is minus 2 by 3. X is equal to minus 2 by 3, substitute in this place. See, f of x value if I substitute minus 2 by 3, will get value after simplified minus 2. This step is not necessary. Next is, minus 2 by 3 comma infinity. If I take from the interval minus 2 by 3 comma infinity, we'll get the value, this in between, if I choose some value, if I substitute in the derivative f dash of x in the place, we'll get value positive. Positive means greater than 0. Greater than 0 means f is increasing. Already I said, first interval if I get decreasing, next interval if I get increasing in the case. From x value, domain of f is x is increases in the case, the given function is local minimum. So f is local minimum. See, in this one, last conclusion how to write means the local minimum value of f is minus 2. See, the local minimum value of f is minus 2. Thus, the local minimum value of f is minus 2. But what the point? Which point will get the local maximum minimum value is minus 2 means the point of local minima at x is equal to minus 2 by 3 means in this point, x is equal to minus 2 by 3, we will get the value, local max minimum value is minus 2. Then what about in this case, whether we will get a maximum? No. Means, there is no local maximum. There is no local maximum value of f and no point of f and there is no point of f. This is the conclusion. value. This is the method to apply first derivative test.